Well, it was a heck of a shot that you landed tonight. Yeah. Did you expect the fight to end the way that it ended? Because it felt a bit abrupt at the time.
Do you know what? That punch, I felt it go through. I felt it, if you get what I mean, I felt it. So I was expecting him to go down, but I wasn't expecting for it to get stopped. But like I said, it happens for a reason, and it happens the way it meant to happen.
His coach was complaining, right? But I could see the fighter's eyes, and I could see he was sort of all right with being stopped. Then when he saw his coach complaining, he was like, "Hold on, what's going on here?" So it was quite amusing. But all goes to plan, then everything as you wanted.
Yeah, absolutely. Like, I didn't go in there looking for it to stop someone. All I care about is the next punch, because that's the punch that matters. So when I get in there, I just want to execute my game plan that my coach gave me, and that's what's important to me. And if it comes, it comes, and it came today.
You're always talking about marginal gains. That's what it's all about. Every fight, marginal gains. So what was the marginal gain this time?
Today, marginal gain from this one. The thing is, I base it on a camp. So, for example, we had a great camp, 8 weeks long, obviously for a 6-round fight, we're praying for that. So we really went in the camp. And what we saw today was more power. So that marginal gain, increase in power, increase in size, increase in strength, and that's what it's all about.
We've been pro for a year now. This was fight number 5, right? It's fight number 5. I heard you do an interview in the week, and you talked about how you are writing the story of your life. You're the one with the pen. So this is chapter 1. 1 year has been completed. How will you look back on it?
Do you know what? I don't look back on it, because what's done is done. And if you dwell on the past, then you're going to crash in the front. So I don't really think about that. Yeah, it's been a great year. I'm blessed and grateful for the opportunities that Francis and Frank and BT Sport have gave me. So I'm grateful for that. Going forward, bigger and better things to come.
Karol, what's a perfect 2022 for you?
Perfect 2022 for me would be another 4 or 5 fights. That'd be fantastic. And a finishing of the year in an 8-round contest. Can't ask for much of that, can you?
Anyone you want to thank? Any final words, Karol?
No, just thank you for everyone. Like I said, BT, Francis, Frank, the whole team, my coaches, my family. I'm really grateful for everyone.
Congratulations.
Thank you.